Would you look at that? I finally got my grubby little mitts on a 40 series GPU. This is an RTX 4070 Ti, and in today's video, I'm gonna test it in 5 games that have been on Steam's most played list for as long as I can remember, to see how this performs in games that you're playing. And then, I'm gonna pit it against a significantly cheaper, but also very powerful graphics card to establish just how much more gaming you're getting compared to a good value from the previous generation for its frankly obscene asking price. The 4070 Ti in question is some PNY variant that I've not been able to find for sale anywhere, but I got it through one of Corsair's build kits that Anna put together in the last video. The card comes with an overcompensatingly massive triple slot cooler on it, with the now very trendy through backplate airflow design. The cooler shroud is a bit plasticky for my liking, but at least you get a metal-ish backplate. And at the end of the stubby PCB, we have a 16-pin power connector. All in all, it's a pretty basic version of the 4070 Ti, but it's got it where it counts. Having said that, let's do a quick teardown before we throw this card at some of the most addictive games on Steam. So this is gonna be my first peek under the hood of a 40 series GPU, and I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty excited. Let's check it out. Yes, that just pops off. So there's actually no contact between the back of the PCB and the backplate. But I don't know how much contact would do considering that we have this like plastic coating on the bottom of the backplate. Now on the back of the PCB, you can see that we've got some ectoplasm all over the place. That's not the kind of thing that I'm used to seeing on a new card. This kind of spunky residue all over the back. PNY was clearly real excited all over the back of these. Other than the excretion all over it, this is such a tiny little PCB. Look at that. It's like, it's so small. And then that says no tearing up on it for some reason. I don't know what they mean by that. Oh, the rear IO shield's keeping things in place. And then this should just pop off, yes. Now I think we can finally get around to popping this off. Yes, that was really easy to do now. Oh! I despise those fan connectors, I really do. But it's okay, they've only been mildly mutilated. There is a lot of fin stack going on, and we'll see what the temperatures are like later on. There are 6 heat pipes running through the length of the cooler. They're not the fattest heat pipes ever, but there's a reasonable amount of them. The PCB is tiny and adorable. There are some power phases all over the place. There's also 12 gigs of GDDR6X on here with our RTX 4070 Ti die in the middle. Ooh, let me clean it off and have a closer look. Yeah, it just looks like any recent Nvidia die. Not entirely sure why I'm disappointed by that, but I was expecting something a bit more exciting under here, like a xenomorph scrotum or something. And after that very reasonable disappointment, it's time to see how this beast runs some Steam esports titles. So Lost Ark is taking its sweet time to launch for the first time. That's not the graphics card's fault. I assume that it's just been busy installing Amazon malware on my system in the process. Now, I'm not going to be testing any of the games at 1080p today, because frankly, if you're buying a 4070 Ti for 1080p gameplay, your money should take a restraining order out on you. So I'm going to start all of the testing at 1440p, and for Lost Ark, I'm going to have the rest of the settings cranked. And just a couple of moments into my first Lost Ark experience, my brain was struggling to process it.
Gunner?
But after choosing a very agile lady character, I was ready for some testing.
Okay, well, straight off the bat, we're pegged at 120 frames per second, and we're just using 45% of the GPU at 37 watts. This $800 graphics card really is putting in some work here.
It doesn't even seem to notice that a game is happening at this point.
Oh, I need to be mashing more buttons, I see. That was the mistake I was making, so that's how you play the game.
So I swiftly swapped to 4K to wake the GPU up a bit.
Hey, there we go. The graphics card is actually having to do things now. We're sitting at about 80% utilization,
but still pegged at 120 frames per second. But despite the higher GPU utilization, we just lost 0.3 of our average FPS, so basically a rounding error worth of performance loss going from 1440p to 4K. So I had to figure out how to unshackle the frame rate to get any kind of useful numbers.
Okay, so now I've actually managed to unblock the frame rate. So we're not just stuck at 120 frames per second now. We're now getting over 300 frames per second, which I think is kind of a minimum requirement. Are you really even gaming if you get less than that?
Sarcasm aside, this time we got a more reasonable performance impact going to 4K, but we were still getting over 120 frames per second.
This is some very fluid lady running in circles action we've got going here. Wait a minute, I may not have played PUBG in a while, but I have hundreds of hours in this game. Why is it forcing me to do AI training matches?
And while I schlep my way through the mandatory basic training, let me quickly tell you about the settings. Again, I started off with 1440p, but this time with everything set to high settings.
So at 1440p high settings, we are getting lots of frame rates. Although, when we do have lots of distance in view, it actually drops to about 160 frames per second. I think that may be more of a game problem than a graphics card problem, considering that we have about 40% utilization and we're barely drawing 100 watts on the GPU. Now, moving over to 4K, when we're looking at the big scene, it's running about the same, although this time we are getting roughly 100% utilization. So the GPU is having to work harder, but that is 140-ish frames per second while looking over the expanse of the map.
But when it comes to a more varied benchmark run, the 4070 Ti does curb stomp PUBG at both 1440p and 4K, even at these much higher than competitive settings.
The first thing to bear in mind with Apex is that it has a frame rate limit out of the box of 144 frames per second. But at 1440p very high settings, that basically doesn't use the RTX 4070 Ti, so I've uncapped it. And again, we're well over 200 frames per second at 1440p, so basically this card is a monster. The 13700K in here is also putting in work. It is feeding the 4070 Ti frames very effectively. Yeah, let's change over to 4K and see what happens. Changing to the native resolution of this display, we're still getting almost 200 frames per second. So we're well over the refresh rate of this monitor.
We're actually getting a surprisingly similar ballpark of frame rate for all of these games. And even with the higher than normal settings I've been testing with, for any of the three games I've tested so far, unless you're running a 240Hz 1440p display or a 120Hz 4K display, the 4070 Ti is mostly an e-bean purchase at this point. But maybe the next game will change that.
Oh, nope, never mind. Dota 2 is not the game in this lineup to change that. Speaking from personal experience, as somebody that's played quite a lot of Dota 2, you'd be hard-pressed to find a system that wouldn't run this game well. You could probably dig out the command computer of an Apollo 11 rocket from 1969, and it would still be able to run the crap out of this game, even at 4K.
And finally, the most popular game on Steam by far, CSGO, is the most convincing argument I've seen for this $800 graphics card in the roundup so far.
At 1440p, you can see here, we're getting well over 500 frames per second. And in terms of GPU utilization, we're sitting at about 50%. That is higher than some of the other games. Yeah, I guess that means that CSGO is worth buying an $800 graphics card for. That's a joke, by the way, it isn't. Although, maybe things change when we switch it over to 4K. Wow, that has barely dropped. Although, we are getting slightly higher GPU utilization, so that's worth it, I guess. Anyway, with that, I think this is a good point to throw in our cheaper previous gen competitor to see how much performance we lose.
Now I get it, this is a slightly unfair comparison, but hear me out for a second. because at the moment, you can consistently get 6700 XTs for under $400. And the last time I checked, aside from some of them occasionally breaking, this is a fire-breathing monster of a graphics card. And I was just curious, in games that most people play, how much more performance are you getting, paying more than double for something even more beastlier? How much graphics card do you really need?
Ooh, yes, we are getting very, very many frame rates here. On this 120Hz monitor, you really miss the 280 frames per second of the 4070 Ti. Actually, jokes aside, let's set it over to 4K and see if the 6700 XT is still saturating the monitor. Now, there's a whole bunch of explosions and death going on here, but this is actually the first time since we've started testing for this video where we haven't gotten a surplus of frame rate for our monitor. Like, what is this unplayable garbage? We're just getting 90 frames per second at 4K very high settings. What an outrage.
Ooh, okay, well, with PUBG at 1440p high settings, indoors we have lost over 100 frames per second compared to the 4070 Ti. But looking into the distance, we're getting about the same frame rate, although this time it's not because of engine limitations, it's because the graphics card's maxed out, which, I don't know, that feels like a bit of a technicality to me. Switching over to 4K, again, we're descending into the depths of unplayability, with a mere 80-ish frames per second at high settings that nobody uses.
I don't know what that does, but it's scaring the crap out of me, and it is kind of tanking the frame rate a little bit.
At 1440p very high settings with Apex, we're getting quite a lot of frame rate with the 6700 XT,
and it feels very stable. Like, look at that frame time graph, it's looking good. Although, of course, the 4070 Ti gave us a lot more performance. We were averaging over 250 frames per second at 1440p with that card.
Now at 4K, while terrible things are happening to my team, we're getting almost half the frame rate of the 4070 Ti. But with more reasonable settings for a competitive shooter, the 6700 XT should still be able to saturate our 4K high refresh rate monitor.
Now with both Dota and CSGO, it's basically not worth testing. With Dota, there was very small fluctuations in frame rate, and even at 4K very high settings. As a keen player, subjectively at 4K, I just couldn't tell a difference between the two graphics cards. With CSGO, there was a bigger difference in frame rate between the two graphics cards, but at 4K, we were still getting almost 400 frames per second with the 6700 XT. So my main takeaway from this video is, why would you buy an $800 plus graphics card if a $350 one performs like this? Especially considering the monitors we all have. But then again, that's only based on a small sample size of very popular games and isn't taking into account things like future-proofing. Anyway, with that, until the next video, subscribe for some more arbitrary comparisons.